Oh, I fucking lost the CDs. Shit. Hey, my coffee's still here. Tasty.
Hello, Internet. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To. So, this week, I want to do another person-themed vlog. The last time I did one of these was for my good friend, Steve the Roommate. For this week's vlog, I want to hone in on yet another very special person in my life. She is the reason why I exist, and she's the reason why I am who I am to this very day. That person is my mother. Because Mother's Day is around the corner, I thought I would take the time to make a video talking about a selection of CDs I have here that she introduced to me or make me think of her or that we've bonded over. And I will just say, I know for a fact, Mom, if you're watching, this is definitely not everything you've shown me. I realized looking at this selection that I forgot some things, but I think that this is a good representation of stuff she's shown me and I've grown to love. So with all that being said, let's get started here. The first album I have here, classic album. This is Fleetwood Mac's Rumours. As far back as I can remember, this was an album that my mom would play in the car all the time. My personal favorite song off this one is The Chain, and my brother's was Never Going Back Again. I remember we even had arguments about which song to play. He would always demand we need to play that song, even going as far as saying, play it again, play it again. But I would always want to play The Chain. I don't know what it was, I just loved that song. Maybe it's because she really liked it and that was the one that stuck to me. But one of the things my mom always used to talk about was she saw Fleetwood Mac perform live sometime in the 70s. It was at an outdoor venue, and at some point during the show, it started raining. But despite the sudden change of weather, she would always comment on how amazing Stevie Nicks looked. The wind was blowing her outfit around, and it made her just look so amazing. And after the song, Stevie even shouted at the audience saying, "You guys are fucking awesome, I love you, you guys are standing out in the rain, this is amazing." So this album means a lot to me, and I know it is a bit generic, but it's a great, great album from start to finish. Every single song off this is great. Fleetwood Mac's Rumours, God, I want to listen to this now that I look at it. Well, did she make you cry, make you break down, shatter your illusions of love? And is it over now? Do you know how? Pick up the pieces and go home. Staying on the topic of 70s rock, the next album I have here is a greatest hits of the Mamas and the Papas. I distinctly remember hearing Dream a Little Dream of Me when I was really, really young. And it's funny because later on in life when I started becoming familiar with the music that she played, I had no idea that the Mamas and the Papas even did that song. I knew Monday Monday and California Dreamin' as a lot of people do, but when Dream a Little Dream came on the CD, I was a little surprised. But this is one of those CDs I completely associate with her. At this point, she must have this on her iPod, at least a couple of these songs, so it's a high likelihood that if she puts her iPod on shuffle that something off this one will come on. But nevertheless, the Mamas and the Papas are fantastic. This particular album has 16 of their greatest hits, as it says. Definitely makes me think of Mom whenever I see these guys. Monday morning, it was all I hoped it would be. Oh, Monday morning, couldn't guarantee. The next album I have here, we're straying into some silly territory. This is The Best of Ray Stevens. I picked this album in particular mostly for the song Guitar Zan. Guitar Zan, he's a guitar man. He's all you can stand. Give him a hand, Guitar Zan. Probably when I was about 10 or 11 years old, we used to bond over really fun music. One of the albums we used to listen to a lot was a Monkees Greatest Hits that had a really funny song called I'm Gonna Buy Me a Dog. I'm gonna buy me a dog.
babe, you need all the friends you can get, I'm telling you.
And because she and I bonded over that song, she thought I might like this guy. I would almost want to call him Weird Al of the 70s. Just completely goofy and satirical stuff. And he would make all these wacky noises. So in Guitar Zan, he would do an impression of a monkey, he would do an impression of Jane screaming, and he would overlay all those vocals together. This album brings back so many memories of us just driving along and laughing hysterically to these songs. If you haven't heard of this guy, I recommend giving him a listen. He definitely has some entertaining songs on here.
And then along came John. Talking Jones. Slow walking Jones.
Slow talking Jones.
Along came Rumbly Lanky Jones.
The next selections I have here come in pairs. I didn't really know which ones to pick, but I figured I'd just grab these two. I have two albums by Stevie Wonder. Not only is my mom really into 70s music like Fleetwood Mac and the Mamas and the Papas, she grew up loving funk and R&B, and Stevie Wonder was one of her, if not her all-time favorite musician. The reason why mom got so into R&B music is because she was a cheerleader when she was in high school, and she always loved listening to songs that just made her dance. To this day, I think she holds on to that philosophy. And I also feel like I should mention that her other favorite band is Earth, Wind & Fire, which I stupidly forgot to grab some CDs of theirs to talk about, but I'll mention it now. Stevie Wonder and Earth, Wind & Fire, probably her top two favorite musicians. So just pretend like I have some Earth, Wind & Fire in this hand, but yeah, these two guys are fantastic. Absolute classics, and they make me think of my mom.
Golden lady, I'd like to go there. Take me right away.
The next selection I have here, I have three albums by Janet Jackson. Once again, I had no idea which one of these to pick because all three of these albums have impacted me in some ways. She must have been listening to these albums so much when I was a child that they're pretty much just ingrained in my memory. Jeez, all of these are just so good. Rhythm Nation was great, Miss You So Much, The Knowledge, State of the World, that's just on one album. I could go on and on just listing my favorite songs in here, but what you should know is that these albums are such a staple to our family. I think these are all flawless albums, and if you have not listened to Janet Jackson, definitely look into these. You will not be disappointed.
The
next album I have here is a bit more of a modern selection. I have Craig David's Born to Do It. Craig came around in must have been late 90s, early 2000s, and I'm not entirely sure how my mom got to know his music, but just one random day we started listening to this album. And like the rest of the albums, this one became a very common thing to put on in the car. A couple of the songs on here have some stories behind them. Key to the Heart I remember hearing in the Osmosis Jones movie, which we saw in theaters, and I remember freaking out and going like, that's Craig David, I know who that is.
Lonely hours, lonely days, never meant to drive you away from me, yeah.
And then the song Rewind was one that my brother, again, always wanted us to play. My brother liked to do this thing with our VHS tapes where he would watch a scene forward motion and then rewind it and watch it backwards. And for some reason, that just made him laugh hysterically. So for Craig to have a song themed around rewinding things, I think my brother took a liking to it. And in retrospect, it is a really cool song. It's the last song on the album, and it's definitely an awesome way to end it. This is great early 2000s R&B music. I recommend checking out this album. It's a lot of fun, and it's got some really good grooves.
Rewind. When the crowd say ball, selector. Rewind. When the crowd say ball, selector. Rewind. When the crowd say ball, selector. Rewind. When the crowd say ball.
And the last things I want to talk about on this video, I have two albums by a band called Iration. When I was a teenager, my mom got really into reggae music. And I think I was the reason she got into Iration. At the time when I first heard about them, they only had one album and one EP out. But on that EP, they had a song on there called Falling.
And I'm
showed her that song and she fell absolutely in love with it. And that song alone really acted as a catalyst to discover a lot of modern day reggae bands. She got into The Expendables, she got into Slightly Stupid, who else did she get into? I think she got into Pepper also. So when Iration finally came out with this album, we picked it up and we listened to it non-stop. Part of the reason we like them so much is because they all come from Waimea in Hawaii, which is where some of my family currently lives. So of course, anytime we would take trips to Hawaii, we would always put this one on. And after listening to this album on repeat for well over 6 months, we finally had the opportunity to go see them perform live. That was an awesome show. And not only was Iration there, but The Expendables were there, and Cisco Adler was also opening for them. So we were pretty excited to see them live, and we were excited about this album, and so when they announced this one, we were even more excited to get new music.
This is the full out soup. Up bottom and they just can't quit. Let the bass hit right on time. Running hard to the end, put you in a panic. Automatic smile, knowing you be mine.
Sadly, this was the first album they put out after they lost one of their members, which we both thought was a key component to their vocals. And while we felt some of the songs lacked his vocal contributions, we still love this album to death. There's just some fantastic cuts on here. Automatic, Show Me the Way, Mr. Operator, Home, Flying High, Runaway. God, this is just such a great album. We've kind of fallen off following Iration because they've started straying a little away from reggae and focusing more on being an alternative rock band. But these albums we have definitely bonded over. We still love them to this very day, and even the last time we went to Hawaii, we were listening to them.
Mr. Operator, don't stop. The night is young.
Okay, internet, that does it for me. I'm not even gonna ask you to suggest some stuff for me because this is all stuff that my mom has suggested. I know that she's watching this now and is probably gonna ask me why I didn't include this album, why didn't I include this album, and the reason is because I just forgot. I'm sorry, Mom. But thank you all for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the things that I've shown you. And Mom, happy Mother's Day. I love you to death. Thank you for everything that you've given me. You are the absolute best. I'll see you all on the next video. Goodbye.